The fucking Lovecraftian demon that is the YouTube algorithm now demands that I make a 20-minute video essay bitching about stuff. So here you all go! Gamers, what the fuck happened to YouTube? No, really, like, what the fuck happened to YouTube over the years? I've been racking my brain trying to think about it for the last couple weeks. Unlike you fucking kids, I'm getting fucking old, man. I've been on this platform a minute. I started out as a kid in 2008, watching Chris O'Neill animations and stupid Mario Brothers and other fucking classics like that. But over time, I've been able to witness YouTube go from a funny little website where you share animations and little spoof videos and machinimas to an entirely different type of beast that's begin to eclipse cable television and legacy media at large, which has been very exciting and terrifying watching a company like Google get a fucking monopoly over media like it has. If you're in your 20s, you've probably been watching this platform long enough to witness people who you idolized in middle school get canceled for being kitty diddlers and talking to 12-year-olds on the internet. Long gone are the days where YouTube existed as a fun little place to share videos, and now it only instills a type of cosmic dread that only people in fucking art and psychology have the fucking capacity to actually accurately express the inhuman amount of dread that fucking YouTube instills nowadays in society. Don't get me wrong, I fucking love YouTube. I love making YouTube videos. I started actually making content of my own about half a year ago, and it's been an absolute fucking blast. I've had a great time, and I've actually made a couple friends doing so, and you know, it's been really neat to like have my own little niche community of fucking sweaty gamer men that I make videos for. But still, I can't end up looking at my YouTube feed without feeling like some sense of fucking hopelessness or just like absolute societal malaise. And this last week or so, I've begun to like really question what that is and why that is, and I've come to the conclusion, or not really the conclusion, but just out of reminiscing, that YouTube has changed a lot over my lifetime, and now it exists as something completely different from what it was even 10 years ago when I was a kid. Maybe I'm just a depressed fucking gooner who's doom posting here, but I feel in my post-nut clarity, I've realized that I can't be the only one who feels this way. Back in 2012, YouTube used to feel like almost a Wild West type of platform, where anything was possible, and you could really make not a career, but get like some type of following being a creative person. Nowadays, I don't think that's the case anymore. And since the human juicing machine that is the YouTube recommendations algorithm demands that people now make 22-minute videos to get recommended, we're gonna go ahead and dive into why YouTube feels so fucking shitty in the year of our Lord, 2024.
Anyway, what is up, guys? My name is PewDiePie.
How's it going, bros?
My name is PewDiePie.
Aaron, don't leave! Aaron, don't! Aaron!
No, I'm fucking done.
No, you're not.
This is bullshit.
I'm gonna go.
Fuck drum.
Skibbity boop bop. Skibbity bay.
Ah.
What?
This does not even deserve the captain's log introduction, because this is dead serious.
Back when I was a wee little honky on the internet, YouTube used to be a place. It used to be a fun place where I could go and I'd find content of many different types. You know, you had Let's Plays, you had your like regular comedy channels, and you had, you had other like neat projects like that and animation channels and all good shit on YouTube. After 2020, the only thing you can fucking find on YouTube is a video of somebody holding a microphone and complaining about the economy for 20 fucking minutes. Like, man, don't even get me wrong, I fucking love complaining as much as the next guy, but I open YouTube these days and it just makes me fucking depressed because it's just filled with a bunch of fucking people crying about their lives, and that's like the most popular form of content now on YouTube. Is just I have TikToks of people fucking crying into their phone screens. YouTube used to be a fucking actual platform that made people feel original and like they were doing something. And after the 2016 adpocalypse, YouTube kind of stopped being this Wild West and turned into basically a gentrified Californian neighborhood for people with high incomes to express their opinions. I'd say from 2010 to 2016 was what you could call the real golden era of YouTube, where you'd find the most amount of differentiating and fun channels. You know, shit was really popping off back then, and it's not until today that I realize what we really had and lost. Used to gain popularity pretty organically on YouTube. Nowadays, YouTube operates a little bit like a slot machine casino. And anybody that's like a professional like card player or like gambler will tell you that anybody who plays a slot machine is a fucking I forgot I can't say the tarred word on YouTube. They're fucking idiots, right? Like, and, you know, that's kind of honestly what the algorithm is like. Early on in me posting videos, I was lucky enough to hit what we like to call an algorithm jackpot, see? Which meant I basically made a shit post that was so calculated that was something that YouTube was eating up at the time, which was Baldur's Gate 3, that it fucking showed it to a shit ton of people, and out of nowhere, I got 15,000 views on this motherfucker, and it was insane. And it's kind of interesting when that happens. When you hit a little algorithm jackpot like that, it actually, not only will it show your video to a shit ton more people than it would normally on the metrics. Like, it'll fucking put it in the recommended way more than it would any of your other shit. But it also gives all of your other videos a small boost and helps kind of like snowball your shit forward to like get your channel off the ground. And the fucked up thing is, I know so many channels who are making amazing fucking content that I know people would like and would enjoy, and that there's a market for, but because they haven't, like, hit this fucking gold mine of, like, keywords that YouTube likes to have as a subject matter for a video, YouTube will never show their videos to anybody, and they're just throwing their effort out into the fucking void. The algorithm is a lot like a slot machine, whereas when you play card games, you kind of can mathematically calculate the odds and you know rules. So casinos prefer slot machines, where a slot machine purposefully obfuscates the rules so that you don't know what the actual odds of your bets are. YouTube works in the same way. It gives you a vague notion of what it would like to see from a video just based on its recommendations. But that really changes every day, and honestly, how many views you fucking get is often based on luck. I find that the three main things that determines your ranking on the algorithm are, number one, mostly, is previous success of the channel. If your channel, is getting a lot of views, YouTube's more likely to show it to people because they know that catches people's eyes. The second, I would say, is, literally, yeah, that slot machine of fucking having the right tags and subject matter. And the third factor in where your ranking is on the slot machine algorithm is time. YouTube will decide that it likes different lengths of videos at different times. During the months where YouTube was really trying to emulate TikTok, they've decided that sub 10-minute videos were the real kickers. Like, short-form content was king, so that was what was getting recommended on the algorithm the most and really boosting people's shit. Recently, YouTube decided that it's 20-minute to 1 hour long videos now, video essays. So basically, on any given month, YouTube will cycle between recommending 2 minute long videos, 10 minute long videos, or 30 minute long videos, depending on how it feels. This makes YouTube actually an interesting prospect for people because it isn't like the old days where you could just, you know, you could just fucking upload 300 parts of a Let's Play that you cut into 10-minute sections and make a quadrillion dollars and fucking jumpstart a career off of that. No, you gotta put more effort into it. People nowadays, they kind of have to branch out into different projects.
Dude, I'm so fucking sick of NordVPN ads, dude. I'm so fucking sick of World of Tanks, of Raid Shadow Legends, of fucking Dollar Shave Club. I'm so fucking sick of the fucking people with the fucking ball trimmer fucking sponsorships, dude. I don't want to shave my balls. I like my balls hairy, okay? Stop telling me to shave my fucking balls, YouTube. I'm so fucking sick of having to skip 3 minutes of a fucking 10-minute long video of somebody talking at the fucking camera. I'm so fucking sick of it. I'm fucking God fucking damn it.
Everywhere I go, it's fucking, oh, this video is sponsored by Raid Shadow Legends. This video was sponsored by Dollar Shave Club. But before we get into this video, let's talk about why internet security is important. With NordVPN, you can fucking suck my fucking dick, dude. Suck my fucking dick, dude. We fucking went from cable television to Netflix to escape ads, and then when ads came to Netflix, we fucking went to YouTube and other shit, and now I can't even escape fucking being bombarded by ads everywhere I fucking go, and it's fucking on YouTube. I'm so fucking sick of World of Tanks ads. I'm so fucking sick of it. I fucking blame JonTron. He's the one that fucking started this bullshit of a fucking Raid Shadow Legends piece of fucking shit. I'm tired, boss. I'm fucking tired, dude. Like, there's something about YouTube now that, like, it just feels so disingenuous.
and corporatized. Even the people that I used to like just feel like fucking disingenuous and corporatized now, because they make all this money and now they're a business instead of an actual fucking person. They've commodified themselves. I'm so fucking sick of Raid Shadow Legends ads. And you know, I know that's like kind of hypocritical because I'm on YouTube, right? And it's like the only way to escape the fucking end times that are coming, or to become an influencer of some type to get those fucking ad revenue dollars. Like, everybody's just given up hopes of fucking actually being in real society and they want to be a fucking YouTuber now. But like, man, I'm just like, I don't know, man. I'm like, I feel like everybody's just fucking sold out. Maybe I'm just fucking being a doomer, but like, I cringe so hard every time I see these stupid fucking like built-in ads, and like especially the ones that like even try to do it well and like work it into their content. I'm like, you're just a fucking loser. Fucking God. I swear to God, man, that I'm like, I much rather prefer when somebody just, like, plugs their own donations or some shit like that instead of, fucking making a 3-minute phone game ad on a 10-minute video, or making a fucking, like, huge-ass fucking ad for some product they don't fucking use that I know they got paid a shit ton of money to make. Like, it's lame as fuck, and it makes YouTube feel like it's a fucking, like, it's no longer a place to post videos. It's a place for people to market themselves and everything they are for the highest, for the fucking lowest bidder of whoever wants to use them as a voice to sell their fucking slop. And I'm just fucking watching YouTube just doesn't fucking give me, like, it just pisses me off nowadays for no reason, and I don't fucking know why. So I ask gamers, what the fuck am I doing right now? What the fuck have I been doing right now? Well, I'm making videos for the sillies, for the funds. That's right, you thought I was gonna stop making YouTube videos? Bitch, you're fucking wrong. You see, for the past fucking however many weeks, I've been practicing my lukewarm fucking bad fucking Adobe Premiere skills with these Kenshi edits, so I can fucking get good at making YouTube videos, so I can produce better and longer and more cohesive shit for y'all. The only way to fight this fucking terrible shit pile that YouTube has become is to start shit posting better and harder than I ever have before, and that's what YouTube in 2024 is going to bring this little honky here. For the past couple weeks of my channel, I've been making weekly edits, and trying to really keep up on shit that's weekly. And currently I decided that it'd be better if I took a shift, and instead of just shit posting every week consistently, now I feel like I have a good enough framework on my channel that I can start making, I want to start making longer shit and making better shit. So I would expect more You know, I expect a lot more gaming videos. You know, they might not be coming out as frequently, but I plan to have them a lot more cohesive. Hopefully a little more intelligently put together. A lot funnier than my fucking just ramblings that I do that somehow still get a tremendous amount of views. Thank you all for your fucking support. You're all amazing. But yeah, I plan to hopefully do some higher quality, longer form stuff about Kenshi, and, you know, making some videos talking about my, some of my other favorite games, like Noida, but I would plan, all of these videos, I would plan not to see them weekly, hopefully trying to keep to, like, once every 2 or 3 weeks. I want to push something, like, out that's, like, 30 minutes that I'm really proud of, you know? And, like, this video, this shit post here is, I guess, something of an attempt at that to try and, you know, get a more cohesive vision for what my shitposting channel is gonna be. At the end of the day, this has been an amazing hobby, and I just want to keep feeling like I'm getting better and better at it, and I keep wanting to improve, and I feel like just making little videos, I can't really improve on that. So I feel like if I make some longer shit, hopefully, you know, some of y'all will stick around and will like it. But if you even got this far into the video, thank you so much for watching. Thank anybody who watches this. I hope you all have a wonderful night. Fuck, I still got a whole goddamn 30 seconds I gotta fucking take up to make this 22 minutes. Jesus fucking Christ. I just want to play Fallout New Vegas. Anyways, oh yeah, once I figure out how to record Fallout New Vegas, expect some videos of that. But yeah, expect better, longer videos from the Honky with a Boomstick channel in the future, gamers. Anyways, this has been your favorite internet schizo puppy dog for another unhinged rant that the YouTube algorithm is going to fucking immediately put in the trash. Thank you all. I love you all. Good night.